Germanisch ist eben der lehrreich vorbei. Alex, was soll ich Deutsch oder Englisch sprechen?
Deutsch.
Ja?
Deutsch. Well, ich kann kein Deutsch. this is sort of a birthday gift to my mama. So I decided to do some stand-up comedy. So this is where you clap for me. So. I'm so glad to be in Germany once again. I have learned a lot from my trips here. I've learned the fact that the Germans in my country aren't as nice as the ones here, because they make Germans sound like they're about to kill you. Good afternoon. I'm like, calm down. It's good afternoon. And they mention words that could murder you, like Krankenwagen. So that was that, an ambulance. And I learned a new word from my host brother, Julian, which I still cannot say. It's supposed to be squirrel. I can't. Yeah, I'll just say squirrel. Usually before I do stand up anywhere, I like to tell people about myself. My name is James Brown. Yes, that's my real name. For those of you who are older, you might know that guy. That's my name. My name is James Brown. I have no idea what my parents were doing when they named me. That's my name. And I have two siblings, a big brother and a little sister. And my sister got the beauty, my brother got the brains. So that explains my occupation now. And mothers are usually proud of their sons when their friends visit. My son is a doctor, my son is a lawyer. What does your son do? My son. He's a public speaker. Public speaking job. Just for girls, for speaking to girls, I don't say I'm a comedian. I tell them I'm a humor therapist. That sounds like I do something much sensible with a degree or something. But no one calls me a comedian, I'm a humor therapist. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. And also, I have this problem with my friends from Europe. And you know, they go like, it's cold in Europe. But they don't emphasize on how cold it is. I'm a black man from Africa, like center of the planet, that's where the sun shines. So I get to Frankfurt Airport in October. It's a very bad idea. That was just 0 degrees. I've never seen zero before. I walked out of the airport, stood there for 5 minutes and went back in. I put on my suitcase to get out. Yeah. You have to emphasize on it's cold. If it ever goes anywhere close to 20 degrees in Ghana, we'll wear winter jackets. And I know my foreign friends are like in shorts. It's normal. No, it's not normal. To get to zero, I have to enter a deep freezer. And that's the only place I'll see that kind of cold. And, how many of you have been to Ghana before? 1, 2, 3, and someone here, right? Well, for those of you who have not been there, you should come there. There's a lot of beach, so you can wear shorts. And not this thing you call spring and rain. No, proper sun, like, yeah. You can get tan, ladies, tan. And one thing you need to know about Ghanaians is they're so friendly, it's annoying. like friendly is, maybe I need directions to a place and I want to go to Selva Castra. For some funny reason, everything in Ghana is straight. I go straight. Okay. I can't find a place to come along. They'll stop whatever they are doing and take you there. And that's how friendly we are, especially to foreign people. Another thing you need to know about Ghanaians is we always answer questions with questions. Same scenario, I want directions to I know it's time tunnels. Do you know Niedenhausen? If I knew Niedenhausen, I wouldn't be asking you. You have to know somewhere to go somewhere. That's why you don't have Ghanaian GPS, because you never get anywhere. GPS will always ask you if you know somewhere to get somewhere. And for that reason, I think that Adam and Eve should have been Ghanaians. Because the snake would have had a very tough time convincing Eve to eat the apple. Why should I eat the apple? That's how weird we are. Thank you for listening to my nonsense. And for the first time in my life, I've made Germans laugh.